Hello everyone. I'm going to be taking us all through a look at my workflow in Fruity Loops. Okay, so over here I have a little bit, the first minute of the Twilight Princess symphonic movement in sheet music made in Sibelius. And I'm going to do what I normally do and transfer it over to Fruity Loops. So right over here I have all of my samples loaded up, such as the violin. And firstly, this is my template file, so I'm going to save it over. Right, now that I have that done, I'm going to start getting this transferred over. So first, I'm going to start on the first violin. So I'm basically just taking these notes over here and just putting them into the program. And actually, since there is a cadenza right here, I'm going to start two beats later than normal. Alright. So then one beat will be waiting, and then it'll be the same thing again. And on our next section, we can just start on the first beat right here. Alright. Now, to do dynamics, I'm going to have to go into here, and what you normally would do is use a mod wheel to make this go up and down, to make the dynamics go up and down like up here. But what I do is I go up here, browse parameters, right-click dynamics, and I create an automation clip. So it's this little thing right here, so I'm just gonna start it way at the bottom. And then might go to about there. And then back down, not all the way, but close enough. And I'll actually stretch this out all the way. So right here. Now crescendo again to about right there and end right here. So if you listen, on something I forgot to do is set the tempo, but that's not too hard. You just go up here, just set it to what I have, which is 60. So we can hear, just gonna make this a little bit more of a slope. Right, so we're gonna do the same thing with the second violin. Actually, for the purposes of this, as you can see, we have the same note, but I don't really want to stack them because it might make it a little too loud. So I'm just going to skip the first note. Actually, no. I'm going to see how it sounds first. So I'm just going to copy this, bring it over to violin 2, and then just move these notes down. And then I'll go into violin 2 and do the same thing. Alright, and just kind of copy the general layout. About right there, 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 bring this one to here. And you can straighten these out by just right clicking and bring this down to the very bottom. Then I think that sounds pretty good. Maybe just take these last dynamics down a little bit. Might actually be better just to keep them kind of all over at the bottom. I'll just see how that sounds. I'll move on to the viola. It's pretty simple. It's the same basic thing. Okay, so we have a D flat right here. Strange thing about Fruity Loops is it only has sharps, but same thing, C sharp, D flat. And then we have an F. Then same thing again. Alright, so then we just do the dynamics for the viola. Alright, so now I just check. Sounds good. So yeah, that sounds good. Now move on to the cello. Do the dynamics. One thing you might want to do is you might have the lower voices go a little bit higher in dynamics. I've learned it sounds has a lot richer tone to it, but I don't know. Now to the contrabass. And to get these little extra nodes right here, I'm just right clicking. Now I can just. I'm gonna do the harp first, actually. So, it's pretty much the same. Go into the harp right here. And. Except the difference with the harp is that. For dynamics, use the little velocity thing down here. So, want it to have a fairly low velocity. I'm actually going to go in here and change this to the slide. That just, in my opinion, sounds a little better. This little arpeggiated chord, there's nothing really too fancy. I'll just take the step down way low just kind of. Actually, it might need to be a little closer. Yeah, that sounds good. All right. And that's just the same thing, except it's gonna be. Right here, and this is gonna be doubled and octave down. All right, now it's gonna be doubled an octave up. Excuse me. And then this is gonna have an F up here too. Listening back. I actually might want to turn the velocity up on some of these. So, little too much. Actually, it might have just been good where it was. I'm just gonna take these ones, turn the velocity up, see how that goes. Yeah, that sounds pretty good. All right. So now I move on to the choir, right here. Okay. So I have that right here. I'm just gonna make sure the vowel is set to ah. All right. So I'll just go in here. Then there's some weird thing with the velocity, but it's kind of whatever. All right. So this is just double an octave down right here in the tenors. So I'm actually going to bring it down here to have the male voices. So it's females up here, male down here. Then have the bass. Then do the same thing with the dynamics we did earlier. Browse parameters. And then find modulation wheel, because some things aren't labeled as dynamics, like this one, there's no dynamics. So you just have to find the one that says modulation wheel. And that should sound pretty good. And I might have the choir go a little louder as well, so you can really hear the choir. So now, see how it sounds. Actually, go up in here and turn the choir up because I can't quite hear them. Alright, that sounds pretty good. Now, I'll just go into percussion one and add the tubular bells, which seems I didn't load, so I'm just going to do that real quick. I'll just go in here, unload that, and then find tubular bells. They might have to be a little bit turned up to hear them. Then I'll rename to the tubular bells. So then I'll go here, and then, oh, that's loud. I'm going here real quick. Just kind of check everything. So you'll probably make this note a little louder. Be a little too loud. So I think that's a good start. All right. So then, now I'm going to move on to where the woodwinds are in the next part. So we're going to start at measure 7 on the flute. Measure 7. And go ahead and throw a key switch down here. Now what these do is all these things up here, legato, long, marcato, they'll correspond to these little key switches way at the bottom of the keyboard where no instrument can really reach. So you have all these down here. I'll set it to this one. And then I'll start writing. I'm actually going to turn the step a little bit higher. Now we're going to do the same thing with dynamics. In case you couldn't tell, this whole dynamics thing is a recurring theme. Alright. Rise up. Make this straight. And we're going to make this one last almost the whole measure, but not quite. This one's going to rise a little bit higher than the others. And then this one goes all the way down. Sort of. Actually, I want this to go back. So it goes. Alright, and I just realized I don't have a solo oboe, so I'm just gonna real quick load that up. That might be a little louder, so you can hear it really well. I'll rename this to oboe solo. Alright, I'm just gonna start right here. We're going to redo the dynamics for it. I'm going to start it right here where it comes in. So we're going to go right here. I actually think I'm gonna turn the oboe up a little bit. Alright, see how that sounds. You can also listen to it on its own by right clicking the pattern. Oh, make sure you have the dynamics there too. All right, that sounds good. Now we can move on to the bassoon right here. All right, just go into the piano roll. Start at 7. That I can do the dynamics for the bassoon. I make the bassoon a little louder too. Dynamics, create an automation clip, and then do kind of the same pattern as the flute here. So that sounds good. And then we'll get the harp. What I normally do is I go in order, top to bottom, from a certain section, normally 4 to 8 measures in length. So now I'll get the harp, some triplets. So what I'm actually going to do, go up here to step, type 1/3 beat. Just kind of copy all this stuff over, make minor adjustments. Get this one, bring it over here. And then make a crescendo in the velocity. Kind of just do this, kind of draw a little curve. Onto the violin, which it's just the flute pattern. So I'm just gonna copy this, put it over the violin, and then I'm gonna bring this violin dynamics, make unique, so it's a new one. So now I can just make it the same. Actually want to make the violin dynamics a little bit softer so you can hear all of the woodwinds. All So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the oboe up a lot, but then tone down the dynamics. So you can still hear it, but it won't, you know, burst your eardrums. About right, and then move on to the viola, and that's the same as the bassoon, so I'm just going to take this over and paste it into the viola, and then I'm going to bring this, make unique, and then kind of copy the bassoon with a little bit less of a little bit lower dynamics because strings tend to be really loud, but that's a good thing for when they need to be really loud, but right now it's not the case. Right. As you can see, already really loud. I might turn down the viola even more. Actually, I have a better idea. I'm gonna keep the viola as default volume, but then just turn the bassoon up even more. All the dynamics down. Still gonna turn down the viola on second thought. Okay, now I'm going to move on to the cello. Oh, forgot to change the step back. Okay. And the same thing, the dynamics as before. I'm actually gonna probably turn up the flute too. Also the harp. Can't really hear the harp.
Thank you.
Cronky base just kind of has a little bloop at the end. Done. So I'm going to move on to the next section, which does include this clarinet section, which I also don't have a solo clarinet loaded, so I guess I'll have to do that too. I'm not going to bother creating a new pattern. I'm just going to load up all the stuff I need. Probably should have done this beforehand, but whatever. So I'm gonna get this quote-unquote English horn, which it's not, but we say it is. Okay. So, okay, this is gonna probably get a little bit annoying because if one measurement, I have to scroll down. But whatever. We're almost to the fun part, just a little bit more. So let's hit that one, then grab the clarinet over here. Actually load my solo clarinet sample. I guess this is a good time to be able to take a look at, you know, how I load all this stuff. Anyway, I forgot to do the dynamics on the other one, but I'll get to that. Okay. What measure was it? It's actually a little before 11. Just gonna keep this little guy over here. And I like that vibe. Maybe I'll make it a little bit lower. But I actually forgot to say these aren't solos anymore. But this is mostly just for me. I know it. I know what I mean. Now I'm going to go to the clarinet one. I don't want stupid vibrato on the clarinet. Anyway, Once that's out of the way. It's over. So I'll get the Cor Anglais, or probably pronounce that really badly, but I'm just gonna call an English horn. The dynamics for the English horn. I'll get those, set them right here. So this one's gonna start around right there, go down right there. I really wanna hear it here. I'm gonna make this go up pretty fast. And this will go down really fast. And then this one's just gonna be going up. Then I'll go down. I'll zoom in here so I can actually do this. Click right here, and then I'll have it go up way fast right here because all this is about to be here. Now for the clarinet. Let's see how this sounds. I really like that. I don't think I need as much vibrato on the clarinet solo though, so I'm gonna turn it down to half. Alright, move this a little bit to the left. I'm going to move this to the right. Yeah, so it kind of hit at the same time. Because the legato sometimes takes its sweet time getting through notes. And now, gotta go to the first clarinets. Get their dynamics. And one thing that sometimes gets annoying, but not really, is that the automation clip will always go the length of the entire piece. I mean, what I probably should be doing is keeping one singular clip through the entire piece, but that'd be too easy. Back. Now I'm gonna do a second clarinet. Should have done that earlier. Didn't grab it. Alright, got this. I'm gonna just take it down to the note, which is A. Right, G. Actually turns out to be perfect that sometimes you gotta make it in the key and stuff. I guess it's just fifths. Kind of just works when you copy and drag it down. It's real simple stuff. Probably really boring too, but sure a few people want to know what I do and gonna turn the clarinets up too. In general, woodwinds kind of need to be turned up to actually be heard. Can't remember, was the clarinet sounded fine, right? Okay, so I'm going to move on to the harp, which is the next part. I think it's just this top part. I think it's just first two copy pasted from the first one. I think this time. Just gonna get a crescendo the whole time. I need to be in triplet mode again. And how I'm doing this, I'm just selecting with it. Control, click, and drag, and holding shift, and then clicking. Actually, already kind of feeling excited hearing this just played back. I'm gonna mute Discord real quick. That's a lot of Discord. All right. Yeah, I don't know what it is, but just hearing this even played back with like only two instruments being active gets me kind of hyped up. It goes into just regular eighth notes. Okay. Make it gradual crescendo and bam. And then there's just some eighth note stuff down here. Should have actually done the velocity stuff after. But whatever. Okay. Let's go down right here. Oh, it's loud. Sometimes it kind of just does a little save. It's going to get a little cramped, but whatever. Just copy these two. And it's just going to go down. Yeah. Pretty easy. See here. Yeah. It's pretty, it gets going pretty fast, you know, the workflow. Once you get going, you just go. Can't wait to hear this all play out. Okay, gotta kind of make it follow the curve now. Next, start on bass clarinet down here. I'm just gonna, I forget what it does. Oh, it goes above. Oops. Okay. So, insert one. Change. Yeah, rename. Bass clarinet. And add a bass clarinet pattern. Just gonna bring it all out here. And I actually have bass clarinet, which would be nice. Clarinet. Go on here. I don't know where I'm starting. 13. Thank you. Dynamics, like always. Always dynamics, no matter what. Need them everywhere. And just do a crescendo. I'll make it a little bit less curved, maybe bring this up a little bit. So more crescendo happens at the end. Okay, sounds really good. I'm just going to go ahead and copy this because it's kind of mirrored in a lot of places. And then there's also one in the contrabassoon. Alright. I'm going to grab this thing, make it unique. Just right click delete on these little notes. The same thing I did with the contra, not contra, but bass clarinet. Hey, guess what? It's the contra bassoon. Actually, needs to be down an octave. And also grab the parameter for the dynamics for the contra bassoon. May look a little messy under the hood, but I mean, it's whatever. Let me give you a little louder. Do I care? Let's see if I care. That over here. Timpani is pretty easy with dynamics too. It's just velocity. Unless it's rolls. Suspended cymbal, so it just kind of does a thing. I'm actually going to turn it up a little bit because these are always too quiet. And the PID. Turn turn that up. Okay. Now I'm on suspend symbol. Trying to think which one. Maybe this one. No. Oh, one is a measure. It's a little noisy with the symbol sometimes, though. Anyway. Gotta go up here. I'm trying to imagine how long I was helped with this stuff. Oh, wow, that's perfect. Just for the heck of it, go ahead and throw this in here. I don't think it's loud enough. Probably good. Okay, then grab percussion too. And then we're gonna go to measure 15. First, we'll do the snare. Key switch for this one is... I forget. D sharp 2. So, for this one, you just kind of have to feel it out. It kind of sucks, you kind of have to wait it out. Actually, I might want to just do a roll. Just kind of do the same things with the other ones. Okay. Now, go to the bass drum, do kind of the same, I think it might actually be... Yeah, I'm gonna do that, D sharp too. Actually, I'm going to just do a regular roll. And then do a bass drum hit right here. Change it back. Yeah, sometimes for whatever reason, doing a roll with dynamics is better than doing a built in crescendo. Not sure what it is. Here we go, so there's a snare drum. so I'm going to turn the bass drum up because I'd like to hear it. I guess I might as well do the same with the timpani. Harp is done. Now, the string. This is probably the coolest part of this. And I'll just copy this. Actually, just to for future, I'm just gonna plop a key switch at the lowest thing, so it just always starts on the default long note. Cause later, oh, I know. Doesn't really matter, but whatever, I got it. And we got violin 2. Just got the exact same. And viola as the same, but knocked it down. Copy violin 2 and viola. Make them all unique. And then I'm just going to kind of do just regular crescendo. Except I'm just going to kind of go back down. I mean, kind of the same as the clarinet. It's gonna go real fast right here. Let's not hear it. This is sound really cool, trust me. It's just takes a while. It's a process. Kind of why it takes so long between videos. Basically, I have an idea for a video as soon as the last one comes out, but kind of making the idea come to life in here. This is only the first minute of almost 11 minutes of the symphonic don't even know how long it's taking right now, but I'm guessing it's probably a while. Let's see how it sounds. Yeah, it's kind of weird in the actual thing. All the strings and, I guess it's not weird, but all the strings and accompaniment kind of decrescendo at the end, but all the low voices and percussion just really kick into high gear right before. If that makes any sense. Okay. Yeah, and when I'm doing stuff like this, I get really excited as to how it's gonna sound complete with it. That all good? Yep. Take cello dynamics. Bring it over here. Make unique. Delete all this extra garbage. And then just bring it up right here. Use the same thing with the contrabass. Make unique. Delete all this garbage. Try not to make 20 new notes like I am right now. Do the thing. Okay, now the cool part. Okay, now the piccolo finally comes in at the last eighth note of 15. So, I'm just gonna. This is a little. It's a little kind of freehanding. You make a septuplet like this. So I'm just gonna go to the last thing here, make it a 16th note, and kind of just take out the scale. Right. What is it? Oh, it is. Then you just kind of shrink it. And then since everything kind of follows the same general rhythm here, except for the horns, of course, and other low voices, I'm just gonna make it here and copy it to all the other ones. This makes the whole thing a lot easier. Okay, how long does it go? One more. Except the string's gone for longer. Come here. Sounds pretty good. And kind of part that sucks is when everything decrescendos like you see here. So you gotta make a bunch of clips and everything for all the instruments. Don't know if there's really an easy way to do that. If anybody wants to tell me, that'd be great. If you can make one specific, like the modulation wheel for every single instrument, I guess. But anyway, onwards. Oh yeah, I should. I just need to take a flute. It's really unique. And just make sure it's the highest level. Elbow up because I always need to hear more elbow. Good. I guess right now I could just go ahead and make these ones decrescendo since all the woodwinds are the same. Make it more of a gradual decrescendo. Go all the way. Okay. And of course I'm gonna export it. Show off the actual full thing at the end. So, might want to stick around for that one. I guess there's one more reason to skip to the end of the video, but whatever. Oh yeah, no, Piccolo, yeah. So I haven't used it. So I'm gonna grab that from here. Dynamics. Create automation clip. And then bring it all back. Take the Piccolo. And just make another day for Shimo. Base clarinet. I think it just gets held for that long. Bassoon, same thing. I don't think I want the contra bassoon to have vibrato. Same thing with bassoon. Ensemble setting, you don't really want vibrato everywhere. Actually, I might want him to get out of the way a little faster so the horn can really blast through everything. But I don't want it to really sound unnatural. Alright, now, get on to the horn. I'm definitely gonna want to turn up the horn. Alright, take the pattern. Sorry about that. So 16. Got this key switch. I kind of have most of them memorized for the most part. What's this? Oh, just kidding. The horns are kind of weird. The key switches. Just one below. I just gotta experiment. trip, it's like this, I just kind of just do that. Just kind of makes it work. No need to change the step or anything. Okay. Okay. Few more of these. Because now I have like trumpets and everything. I'm just gonna turn the trumpets up because trumpets. Alright, go to the pattern. Trumpet one. Delete this little front part. Oh, I think I'm too far ahead. Next. So I'll get trombone 1, 2. So I'm gonna use the quivre samples for this one, which makes it like nice and loud. Oh jeez. Sometimes on the note length is kind of off. You kind of gotta go to a different pattern, kind of click on it. So you kind of store that. So and then right here, I'm gonna change it to this one, which is the longs. So, there's that. Also got to hit the second, third trombone, or second trombone and bass trombone, excuse me. Shouldn't be that difficult. So we're going to use the same key switch. Actually, I don't know why I'm doing this. Mostly what I have the second ones for is for like legato stuff where you can't have multiple notes on the screen at once or like playing at once or just know what to do. But for like this, for example, it doesn't really matter. But this does matter. I need the bass trombone. Trombones are just gonna kind of crescendo over the course of the entire thing. So that sounds pretty fantastic. Now grab the tuba. Some of these kind of stay open sometimes. So just kind of click on. Alright. Now let's get to the tuba. Instruments. It's pretty great. Okay, percussion doesn't really do anything. So now, this is the interesting part. You get the harp doing whatever the heck it wants. Bunch of glissandi. It's kind of hard to make it look any good. Basically, I just do chromatic all the way down to the note.
Okay.
Actually, I'm gonna see if a scale would sound better. I think that sounds better. Going pretty easily. You just kind of mess with it. Until it works. Move this over. Okay, that's another one of these. Just gotta drag this over. Bring this over. Sounds good. And then it goes. Home stretch. Okay, drag this over, and then I think the harp should probably be decrescendo, kind of, throughout all this. And then it's kind of a regular rhythm. Next one. And then should be it for the hard part. Should kind of get quieter as the harp goes up anyway, so. Let's see how it sounds of what we have so far. That's maybe a little too loud, but this is not loud. It's not loud enough now. Sounds really good. I'm just gonna do a little. Choir should be mighty loud. So. No need to worry about volume, I don't think. Okay, choir. Oh, just gonna copy this one. Not violent. What the heck? Okay. Whoa. Oh, oops. Okay. I understand. Oh, the velocity thing. I just can't hear. Alright, that's pretty epic. I think I saw the alto, so might as well. Wait, I don't know if I can really do that, but whatever. No, can't do that. That's fine. I think they're alive enough as is. So, and then we got. Then measure 18. Just got this note. Good. Okay, now I'll take this choir thing, make it unique. Delete all the garbo. Okay. Thank you. are sorted out. Now time to move on to the violins. It's pretty easy, honestly. Just copy this. Actually, I'll just copy the flute since this is exact same note. And just bring it over here. Make it twice as long. Copy this. Violin 2. It's the same note. Feels an octave lower. Alright. So that's it for the normal strings. Actually, I'm just gonna, instead of making a unique thing, I'm just gonna take this, move this up, move this all the way down, make it straight. Do the same with this one. Same with this one. And the cello is probably going to be the same, so I'll just move the cello over. Get that set all the way already. Okay. Contra. Bring this back up. This down. Drag this out here. Alright, now I'm gonna need my violin extra because this has got the tremolos on it. What we are gonna do is have the choir. And just kind of spike in the middle. Have it kind of curved. Take the choir. And you just kind of do the thing. D flat. Got it all set up. I'm just gonna go over here. I'm gonna rename it real quick. Okay. Dynamics. Sounds pretty good. Now reveal, go to this one. I've got B flat. Oh, oops. I have it set to the wrong switch there. Extra. Make sure it's actually set to the right switch. There. Okay, grab the dynamics for both of those. Feel extra. Dynamics. Grab this, stick it right there, resize, and shape. Okay, and then get going for second violin. Alrighty. Now I got the dynamics for the violin 2 tremolos. Now you can just pop this in. A little too loud, not sure. I'm just gonna extend a little bit so everything lasts outside of that. Okay, and that should be it, I think. All right, that's all for how I put this together and everything. And I guess at the end of this video, I'm gonna put what the exported sounds like. Okay. Hopefully there aren't any mistakes. I guess I'll fix them if there are before that, but